So after we have identified the different landmarks in the parasternal long axis view here, we move to the next section. And what are the tips for a better study when we start by examining the parasternal long axis view? The tip here is that we should begin at a higher depth to assess the presence of pericardial or pleural effusion or pores. Note that pores may coexist together, and we won't know this, or we will miss this, if we don't increase the depth, as we speak in the previous lecture about how to adjust the depth. The important thing here is that the descending aorta provides a useful landmark to differentiate between the pericardial effusion and the pleural effusion. How does the descending thoracic aorta, which is this structure just behind the left atrium, differentiate between the pericardial and the pleural? It's so simple idea, and the idea is this: if the black space or the this space which is filled with fluid is in front of the descending thoracic aorta, you notice this black space is just in front of the aorta and behind the left ventricle. This means that this fluid is pericardial effusion. While if you notice that the fluid is beyond the descending thoracic aorta, this is definitely pleural effusion. And the good thing here is that this example shows that the patient have both pleural effusion and pericardial effusion. And we can notice this also in this live video. This is a parasternal long axis view, and you notice that I increase the depth of the view. We can notice that it is reaching until the posterior mediastinum. And here is the landmark that we are speaking about. This is the descending thoracic aorta. Any fluid in front of the descending thoracic aorta, like this fluid, this black space, means this fluid. This is pericardial effusion. While you notice this there is equiparietal membrane, which is the pericardium, then there is other black space here, and there is some sort of gray consolidation tissue, which is a collapsed lung lobule, and this black fluid is the pleural effusion. So in this patient we have both pericardial effusion and pleural effusion. Note that if you started the examination with low depths, if the view ends just here, you will miss this. You will miss this pleural effusion. So it's a very important tip to start the parasternal view in large depths to assess the presence of pericardial or pleural effusion, and then you will adjust the depth and the focus to just examine the parasternal long axis.